afternoon to all of you. Today is a great day in the life of every student at BML Munjal University. We have none other than General Vikram Singh, who was a former chief of I would like to introduce General Vikram Singh, the former Chief of Indian Army and Chairman of Chiefs of Staff. He superannuated on 31st July 2014. During his eventful and distinguished military career of over 42 years, he held a number of key appointments both in India and abroad. Before taking over as the Chief of Army Staff, he was a General Officer Commanding in Chief of the Eastern Command, a field army that is responsible for the Chinese border and the borders with our eastern neighbors, along with the country's insurgency operations in the northeastern states of our country. He also commanded the prestigious Srinagar Base 15 Corps that is responsible for the line of control and counter proxy war operations in the valley. During his earlier tenure as a brigadier in South Kashmir, he was also wounded in counter terrorist operations. He is a graduate from the Defence Service Staff College, Wellington, the Higher Command Course at MAU, and the US Army War College, Pennsylvania, USA, where he won the International Toastmasters Award in Public Speaking. Later in December 2013, he was also inducted into the US Army War College Hall of Fame in an exclusive ceremony organized at the college. On 18th October 2013, he was also awarded the Legion of Merit by the President of the United States for exceptionally meritorious conduct in performance of outstanding services. A round of applause, please.
Jai Hind, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
And a very good afternoon. Let me thank at the outset Dr. Tapan Panda for his kind words and for the invite for me to come over here. I must thank also the other members of the faculty. Dr. Kumar has been very gracious escorting me from my residence from Delhi Kent to this place. I must confess, it's a pleasure being here. I wanted to be here. One place where I have no hesitation in landing up, that is always the such beautiful establishment institutions which are actually training the future leadership of India and global leadership. It's a treat being here. I've gone around the university campus. It's coming up, it's taking roots, I can see that. But it's definitely an institution of excellence. And you all need to be proud of being members of this very prestigious institution. I accepted this invite, I must also confess with you, because of my association with Munjal family. I've studied with Mr. Pawan Munjal, with Mr. Sunil Munjal. And so when I was told to come here, I straight away took the offer to be here with you all. I don't intend today speaking on myself as to what I did. In fact, I had only one slide made, and that was on achievers. You would like to rise in life, would like to achieve and realize your dreams. Most of you seated in this hall today have already thought of what you want to become. Some of you are still very confused, still trying to deliberate as to what exactly you want to achieve. But I must tell you, it is right time today, ladies and gentlemen seated in this hall, that as soon as possible, try and identify for yourself what you want to achieve in life. Because unless you do that, you will be able to not achieve what you want to achieve in a favorable time frame. And I say favorable time frame from the point of view of the competition. It's a very competitive world. There are only X number of vacancies wherever they are. It's a zero-sum game to a large extent, unless you have your own enterprise. And therefore, from that point of view, you've got to have your focus onto your vision, onto your mission, onto your objective, and put all your energies to be able to transform that dream of yours into reality. And now let me start by telling you who are the people who've been achievers, who are the people who succeeded in life. They're the people who dreamt big, people who looked beyond the horizon, people who aim for the sky. And I always say, remember, dreams are not what you get when you sleep, dreams are those that don't let you sleep. So dream big in life, but along with this, it's very important to have attainable aims and goals in life. You must dream big. Dream big, very important from the point of view of what you want to achieve in life. But remember, it is related to your capacity, to your resources. That's very important. And it has got to be gradual attainment of that vision through a process of attaining various objectives which lead towards the attainment of that end state. Because if you do not go that way, there are very bright chances that perhaps you will end up with a heart attack. You can't, for example, CTA said today, say, look, I'm going to be CEO of that organization. You can perhaps gradually look at that position being attained over a period of time. I, as the army chief, couldn't have dreamt of being an army chief as a second lieutenant when I got commissioned into the Indian Army. Because had I not become, I would have suffered a heart attack. So therefore, we train our people in the army. And I'm going to give some examples of the army because, ladies and gentlemen, there is no better leadership than the Indian Army. I must say this. And I say army vis-a-vis Air Force and the Navy. There are three different templates, and I can answer this question should you ask me later on as to what are the differences in the leadership styles in these three services. It is the Indian Army which produces leaders of character and competence. Leaders who take their 30 men into a barrage of bullets to capture an objective because that has got to be done in the national security interests. They have to win. We teach our leaders to win because there are no runners-up in war. There is no second position in war. Either you are a victor or vanquished. So there is too much of focus as far as the leadership in the army is concerned. But getting back onto your vision, I was telling that we in the army train our people, teach them, motivate them to have attainable goals in life. And trust me, when a second lieutenant joins, he passes out from the OTA or from the Indian Military Academy, you ask any youngster as to what is your aim in life, his prompt response would be, I want to command my unit. Attainability. But you won't hear a second lieutenant saying, sir, I want to become a chief like you. So what I'm coming to is, while your aims in life, dreams should be big, and they can be big if you're in the political field. They can be big if you're in the corporate sector. But in an organization, if you join, like the military, you know very well there are a large number of imponderables which are going to be deciding your growth. And therefore, you cannot afford to put your eyes onto an end state which may have far too many intangibles, imponderables coming in to be able to achieve that. But not going back to this aspect of military, let me tell you that you people who are tomorrow looking at the corporate sector, you are into management, most of you into engineering, you have the sky as the limit. And you've got to dream big. So dream big, and thereafter, create capabilities, capacities in yourself to be able to realize that vision. And also, be a good member of a team to be able to run that team in a homogeneous manner to be able to achieve and take everybody along. Ultimately, it's the question of leadership. When you start off initially, you would be alone. But slowly as you grow, you will have two people under you, three people under you, wherever you are, you become a leader. And who are these people who have succeeded in life? Let me tell you some of these benchmarks, some of the things which qualify such personalities. One, of course, as I said earlier, these people dreamt big. They had the passion, the commitment, the focus to be able to achieve what they wanted to achieve. Number two, they adopted a very ethical approach to realize those goals of theirs. It's very easy. You know, I was telling one of the members of the faculty, the other day I was speaking at Symbiosis, and I was asking the kids, you know, during a cup of tea with them, and I was asking each one of them, what is your aim? What is your aim? What is your aim? And there's one lad, a tall guy, a handsome young fellow, who says, sir, my aim is money, money, money in life. So I said, look, I want to answer your question. Here, you come and meet me outside. I'm sure your aim is money, money. You're looking at your friend. I suppose your also aim is money, money, money. Good. Good to have that aim in life. But I said, it perhaps may be better that you say, look, my aim is to develop a capability and be a leader of character and competence so that I can tomorrow earn money, money, money. I said, why don't you look at making yourself competent? A person whose value-based character, who can achieve his ends through scrupulous means. Because if you do not do that, you may be taken astray, some reckless impulses may take you astray, and you will end up doing wrong things in life to be able to achieve the end state of money, money, money. So that's very important, your goals being there and adopting an ethical approach to reach that place. The other point, ladies and gentlemen, is that you've got to continue to work to improve yourself. The most important thing is that if you improve yourself, if you're a good leader yourself, you will be able to deliver and create the right kind of climate and culture that is required in your corporate sector, in your company, in your institution, wherever you are. And from that point of view, it's very important to go by certain values. When I talk of a leader of character and competence, what is character made of? Character is made of attributes and values. And competence is made of skills, knowledge. And when you talk of character, the attributes are in terms of your physical attributes, your emotional attributes, and your mental attributes. Physical attributes, I was told by Mr. Sandhu, who's in charge of your physical development over here. He's into a lot of physical activity. I think it's a very good thing. In addition to honing your mental faculties, in addition to acquiring the sophistication, intellectual sophistication and maturity, you're also being made into robust leaders in terms of strong minds and strong bodies. Because if you have a strong mind, you'll have a strong will. And will, ladies and gentlemen, is the most important mental attribute of any leader. Besides being physically fit, and if you're physically fit, you'll be able to achieve it. Will is that desire which doesn't tell you ever to give up. It enables you to virtually snatch victory from the jaws of defeat. It inspires you to get up every time you're knocked down and keep moving. It's never saying die. Will is the most important thing in life as part of your mental attributes, as I said. Physical attributes, of course, I mentioned, your physical fitness, mental robustness, but in the mental attributes, it's very important. Will is the first thing, which is very, very important. The second attribute, which is very important and will take you places, and this is one of my own experience, is self-discipline and self-control. You should be able to ensure that the inner drive which is there, which comes up as part of the character, the inner compass tells you to go in which direction. You will be confronted with a large number of folks in life. When you move along a path, there will be a number of folks which will come in life. But the beauty lies in selecting the right direction in that fork, going left or right. And that is success, of course. It, to a large extent, also requires the blessings of the lady luck. But if you are pragmatic, if you examine the situation, if you go into the pros and cons, you will never generally go wrong in selecting which direction of the fork you got to take in life. That's very important again. So getting back onto your mental attributes of self-control, it's that you are able to control your impulses. You will come across a large number of opportunities where you got to ensure that these reckless impulses do not ever take you astray and you remain a man of values, a man of character. Amongst the emotional attributes is balance and stability. And that comes with, again, a lot of experience and a lot of training and resilience, mental resilience. In life, you will never get what you want. Your dreams will never be realized. Things will not move the way you planned. But the beauty lies in a good leader, a good human being, to be able to maintain a balance, not throw tantrums, and maintain the emotional stability at all points of time. That's very important.